Blessings to all of you. Greetings to everyone. Today, I'd like to speak with you about balance. You see, there is a lot of talk in a certain scene about the aspects of duality and how we can overcome duality and this kind of things, you know. And maybe you noticed in your life that there has been always a struggle inside of yourself, that you want to overcome certain emotions or you want to overcome certain habits. And it is a series of failing. So how do we overcome things, or how do we find a balance in our life? And it is simply like this. If you look at your spine, if you look at your body, you see your spine is in the center. And the spine itself makes a wave, no, isn't it? Makes a kind of wave. So everywhere we are constructed in our physical body in polarity, we have a left brain half, we have a right brain half, we have a left eye, we have a right eye. And you can call it the negative eye or the positive eye. We have also a third eye, which would be here, and this is the neutral eye. And so for every polarity which you see in your life, for example, the bad attributes of our characteristics, the bad habits of our characteristics, what we call the demonic self. Now, when you look at yourself, you find the good one inside of you and you find the bad one inside of you. Actually, from everything where you think it is a good attribute in me, you find the opposite of it at the other side. And no matter what you try, there is this opposite side there. And it has to be there because the dark is not the bad and the light is the good. It is just two expressions of the same force. And therefore, the darkness, for example, is a reminder. Yeah. Whenever you come in a crisis, whenever you have something where you feel that you fell, you mostly come in a way to a higher attention or to a higher awareness. You see yourself with much more interest and much more attention. While when you fly in happiness, you fly in a love emotion, you do not look at yourself really. You're not really in contact at that moment with the whole. No? And this is the simple reason why most of us experience harder days than easier days. Just simply, it has to do with the way you are in remembrance to the source, in the way you are seeing yourself as a whole. When you start to come to the middle, you know, then you are in contact with the negative side of yourself, and you are in contact with the positive side. And whatever is needed in the moment you need it, you will make it and you will choose it. Gurdjieff used to say, if you want to become successful in this world, you have to become an actor. Yeah. And what is the essence of a good actor? A good actor is not fixed to one role. He can use any kind of role. Like Anthony Hopkins, for example, an actor which I like very much. He used to say, if anyone wants me to play a steak, I can also play a stake, yeah. Just to describe the ability he saw in himself, that he can go to a very bad character and he can go to a very good character. Therefore, there is not I'm that or I'm this. There is just I am. And in the I am-ness, you find balance. It is not that you find always peace, because there is not always peace. There is not always everything happy. There is not always everything in bliss. No matter on which level of awareness you are still here in this third dimension, and that means you are in a dimension of polarity. So, or duality. Yeah. Therefore, we will not have something like a world peace. We have sometimes things like a world war. But what we need to achieve is balance, is harmony, that we allow all the forces to be there. And then not one force has to be coming out because it had been oppressed for a long time. Like if we never consider Earth, for example, if we never consider the elements, no? The elements will show us what is their power and what is their importance. If we never consider ourselves in our weakness, then our weakness will show us that it is the master, no? At a certain time, that you cannot be always strong, that you have a weakness and the weakness has to walk with you. And the same is with fears, and the same is with all these emotions you find. So now we are in the time of integration. And what does that mean? It means simply that you have to learn to organize your life and to see your life in a balanced way, to create a life where you find balance. Just ask yourself one question. If a higher being would come to you and would ask you now, or would tell you, all what is now with you, inside and outside, this is it for the rest of your lifetime, how would you feel then? If you can say, yes, it's fine like this, yeah, it's all right. You have achieved a certain stability and a certain balance. If you have not that, it means you need to see where you create imbalances in your life, which means you look at your relationships, you look at your working situation, and so on and so on. And what you want to change, you need to become. You need it to become it in yourself. Then it will manifest in the outside. So thankfulness, for example, is a great neutralizer of all imbalances. Non-judging would be the exact vertical line to raise up. Yeah. If you develop these two things, you find yourself very quickly in a different life situation. Sometimes the transitions have to be hard. So expect the unexpected. And if you can do that, eventually you will find yourself in a different, more balanced situation. So integration means also to see all these aspects of your life, to see the aspects of our global situation and how we contribute to it and what we can do better in it. This is the time of self-responsibility. So we stop blaming others. We stop accusing any circumstances for our condition. I wish you the very best, and I hope this makes sense for you. So go to work and feel beloved and feel blessed. Thank you very much. All the best.